All right, good evening. Welcome here to the Ophelia Parish Performance Hall here at Truman State University. My name's Chris Parcheski. I am the band vice president of the Northeast Missouri Music Educators Association, and it is my job to put all of this stuff together. So I just want to say thank you for being here. These kids have put in a tremendous amount of work today. They've been working hard, playing a lot, and you're going to have a good program for you tonight. So a couple things real quick, just to give you an idea of what's going on tonight. We have two bands that are going to play this evening. This is the Honorable Mention All District Band, and they are going to play for you. I believe it is four pieces. Then we'll do a quick set change, and the All District Band will come down and play for you. We had auditions Monday night. We had over 300 auditions for the concert bands for these two groups, and there are approximately 160 students that you will see perform this evening out of those 300 that were selected. So this is a good honor for them to be here, and we're excited to have both these groups performing for you. Our clinician for this group is Ann Goodwin-Clark. She's a retired music educator, most recently from Park Hill High School and Cameron High School. She's past president of the Missouri Bandmasters Association and past vice president of the Missouri Missouri Music Educators Association. So without further ado, here is Miss Ann Goodwin-Clark and the Honorable Mention All District Band. Thank you.
Thank you. It's a real treat to be here. And these students, Mr. Barczewski wasn't lying. They have worked so hard today, and I've enjoyed it thoroughly. The first piece we played was a march. You hopefully recognize that. Coast Guard's March by Carl King, the great march composer out of Iowa, Fort Dodge specifically. Almost as famous as John Philip Sousa, certainly around this area. Our next piece is entitled Encanto by a composer named Robert W. Smith, who really kind of reinvented writing for public school music programs in a way that he would write music that was programmatic in nature. I named some of his pieces to the kids. This one is not programmatic, but Mr. Smith tragically passed away earlier this fall, and he was not that old. And so tonight we play Encanto to honor the legacy of Robert W. Smith. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Anytime you're asked to do an honor band, it's a big mystery. I've always known of the reputation of this district for being outstanding. But I also know that since COVID, things change sometimes. And certainly I think last year was the first year in several that this band existed. So I made a mistake when I sent music, because I underestimated these kids, and I learned immediately. There's a beautiful folk song called Ye Banks and Braes of Bonnie Doon, and there's a great arrangement of it, version of it, by the great band composer Percy Grainger. But I thought, that might be too much for an honorable mention group, so I got a little arrangement of it. And we started to play it today, and I immediately texted both Chris Barczewski and Dr. Prendergast and said, do you have the Granger here? Because I think these kids are up for that. So they sight read this today and did a great job with it. And it's been a real treat. It's one of my favorites. Again, the folk song setting by Percy Aldrich Granger. This is Eubanks and Braes of Bonnie Doon. Enjoy.
Before they performed their last piece, just a couple things from me again. For both of these groups, this group and the All District Band, Like I said, they got their music on Monday after auditions, and they had about 6 hours today to put together this concert you're hearing tonight from both groups. So if you think about, you know, our home concerts when we're at school and we have, you know, several weeks or, you know, 12, 14 rehearsals to do this, they did it in 6 hours today. So it's pretty impressive what they've been able to put together and to have a musical concert tonight that quickly. The other thing I would like to do, we like to recognize students that have made either one of these groups multiple times. So in this group, we have several students that this is, and I'm going to step out of the way. If this is your second year making either of the district bands, would you please stand? Also had some students, this was their third year as a member of one of the all-district bands. So third year members, please stand up. So I know with the craziness of, I believe our seniors would have been part of the COVID year that we weren't able to have a rehearsal, but they were recognized in a virtual audition and performance. So we're glad the last 2 years we've been able to put this concert back on stage again and present this for you. So we're really proud of all their hard work today, and I'm going to get out of the way so they can play their last piece for you.
And again, before we play our final number, I want to express my thanks to Chris Barczewski, to all my friends in this district, to the hosting of Truman State University. It's been lovely to see Dr. Tim Oliver again, who went to school here, and you'll get to see him with the Honor Band. So many great programs in this district, which is huge. I had no idea. Some of you have like a 2.5 hour drive after the concert tonight, I know, but what a wonderful legacy in this district, and so many outstanding band directors and programs. I'm going to tell them myself just a little bit. I told the kids this afternoon after rehearsal that, and you know this because you're band parents and band families, but there's nothing like band. There's nothing quite like it in the entire experience of the high school curriculum. And I encourage these students to never quit playing their instrument and never quit participating in a band. I am blessed to conduct a municipal band that plays through the summer. More and more, there are adult concert bands. Certainly at the college level, any of these students would be more than welcome. They would be coveted by college programs. So I encourage them, and I encourage you as their parents, to continue to allow them to be part of such a wonderful activity. I often refer to myself as a band evangelist, and I think most of the teachers that your kids come into contact with are. But thank you again, Chris, and thank you, students, for a tremendous day. One of the things that I started to try to do, I need to stay in my lane and know my limits, but this piece by Todd Stalter is called Critical Mass, and I tried to explain nuclear fission earlier today. If you know me at all, that's really funny. But the point of the title of the piece is that at some point when there's enough energy to create a critical mass, it sustains itself. And you'll notice in this piece of music that the tempo feels almost like it sustains itself, critical mass. But the goal is not to go too fast or play too big, because then it's weighed down in its own energy. And so that's been our challenge. And I think you'll enjoy this this piece, and maybe think of band and not nuclear fission. But thank you again. Critical Mass by Todd Stalter. Thank you.
we get started with this group, I need to say a big thank you to Dr. Curran Prendergast. He was graciously willing to accept my pestering of wanting to host a concert here, and he opened up this building and all of their resources to us and had several student helpers. So big thank you to everybody here at Truman State University for hosting us and letting us use their equipment. This is my second year in this office, and when I was elected to this position to take over the district band and do this, the first message I sent was to Dr. Tim Oliver, and was to get him to come and be our clinician for this group. If you don't know Dr. Oliver, he is the current director of bands at the University of Mississippi, but I really wanted to reach out to him and get him up here to conduct this group because he is a graduate of Centralia High School, and he sat in this, I believe he said was a three-year member of this very band, and was also a Truman State University graduate. So I really wanted to get him here, and it actually worked out that he couldn't do it last year, because now this year he's doing it here at Truman. So it's kind of a great homecoming for him. So this is the All-District Band under the direction of Dr. Tim Oliver.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. It is, as Chris Barczewski just said, it's truly an honor for me to be here for any number of reasons, some of which I'll talk about a little bit later. That first piece was Carnegie Anthem by William Owens. He's an African-American composer, and as you might imagine, with a name like Carnegie, it does in fact go with Carnegie Hall, and I think that's a wonderful way to begin a concert. One of the programming philosophies that I have used for many, many years now is the idea that as directors, we program standard repertoire, contemporary repertoire, collaborative repertoire, chamber repertoire, and music of underrepresented composers, not necessarily in that order. But all of the pieces this evening, with possible exception of collaborative repertoire, are going to be represented on tonight's program. That first piece was contemporary. This next piece, Chorale and Shaker Dance 2, is no question in the standard repertoire. And this is a piece that has been around for quite a while. And one of the things I really like about this piece is that it really shows off the ability of a group like this to be able to have some of those chamber music moments where it's not just everybody playing all the time, but as you'll hear, the music rests frequently on one or two or three people. And so for them to be able to do that on such a short rehearsal turnaround is really quite remarkable. So John Zdechlik, Chorale and Shaker Dance 2.
Thank you.
Love that piece. That's a great, great piece. So this next piece is actually a newer piece. This is more of the contemporary repertoire. And this particular piece is called Chasing Sunlight by Kate Nishimura. And Kate Nishimura is a Japanese-Canadian composer. And this particular piece is all about literally chasing the sun as, you know, you're trying to get to the horizon, or lately, you know, daylight savings time, whatever the case may be. But the idea of that we're chasing this, and the way that this piece ends is really kind of creative because it just sort of evaporates and it's just like, ah, and now we have the night. So this is a really creative piece. And the thing I shared with the students is that not all great music has to be like the hardest thing ever. And of the pieces that we're playing tonight, this is the easiest one. Remember what I told you about compliments, right? Okay. So I hope you enjoy this piece. This is something that's it's a new piece to me, and I'm hopefully they've enjoyed exploring it as well. So Chasing Sunlight. The most prolific composers for wind bands of the last probably 20 years is Frank DiKelly. I'm willing to bet that most of these students, before they came to this experience today, had played at least one Frank DiKelly piece. And this particular piece, I think, is really, really creative for a couple of different reasons. First, if you know anything about the story and the story behind the song Loch Lomond, the idea here is that there are two soldiers. And this is in the Scottish wars of, like, you know, not quite like Braveheart or something, but of that kind of era. And one soldier is captured, and it's sort of like a prisoner exchange type of thing, and they're willing, the other side is willing to let that soldier go, but somebody else has to take that soldier's place. And so the idea here is that there's this sort of, you know, tale of sacrifice, and as the song lyrics go, the idea is that you take the high road. In other words, you get to go home, and I'll take the low road, and I'll stay here and presumably perish. And so I think the way that Tekeli interweaves this, I think, is really creative. And again, you'll hear some a lot of full ensemble playing, but you'll hear some interesting counterpoint, and you'll also hear like literally one or two people playing on some occasions. And if you're listening very closely and we do our job right, it'll be a nice little musical surprise. There's actually a second folk song that is interwoven here at the end. So Frank Tekeli's Loch Lomond. Thank you.
couple more things from me, but I'll make it quick. Part of our organization, or the band area of our organization, with some of the funds we have available after we bring in our clinicians and all of these things, we like to give a couple rewards. And one of those is a band grant. Directors can apply for a band grant from the district. It's not a large sum of money, but if there's like a purchase they're looking to make in any way that we can supplement that purchase, whether it's to buy music or help purchase an instrument of some sort, like go towards a purchase they're doing, they can submit a band grant. And then I have a committee of directors look that over and look through all of those and select one of those to award that honor to. This year, the band grant went to Schuyler County. And I gave Mr. Aishelman his money so he didn't have to trek all the way down here to the stage. But so congratulations to them. And then we also give out a scholarship to a senior who is planning to pursue a course of study of some sort in music next year at the college level. And they also have to be a minimum of a 2-year member of either the all-district concert bands or the all-district jazz bands. And we had applicants this year, and our recipient this year is Jessica Owens from West Tran High School. So Jessica, I do not have money for you right now, but I will be in touch with you and let you know how we can take care of that. Okay? And then lastly, I would like to recognize our second, third, and fourth year members of this group as well. So I'm going to step out of the way again. If you are a 2-year member of this ensemble, either of the district bands, would you please stand? This is your second time. If this is your third year as a member of one of the bands, would you please stand? And lastly, if you are a 4-year member of either one of the groups, you were a member of all 4 years, would you please stand up to be recognized? And I didn't tell them I was going to do this, but honorable mention students that are up around the top and students on stage, would you also help me and thank all of the wonderful people that came to see you, that take you to band practices, that bought you an instrument, that go buy you reeds, all of those things you need. Would you please thank them for being big supporters? Thank you so much for coming out, and I will turn it back over to Dr. Oliver.
So thank you all very much for being here. I am a band parent myself. I have a senior in college and a senior in high school right now, so I know exactly what that's like. Sidebar. This should not be, if they're a senior, this should not be the last year they play their instruments, okay? I know Ms. Goodwin said that as well, and she's absolutely right, in the sense that this could be a lifelong activity. And I can tell you, I've been a college professor for 24 years now. There are multiple scholarship opportunities to continue at the college level, even if you're not a music major, okay? Most college marching bands that you see, 2/3, 3/4 of them, are not music majors. So just be aware of that as you're thinking about your plans moving forward. As was mentioned earlier, I am an alum, if you will, of this particular ensemble. I'm very fortunate that I get to do this type of thing all over the country. And of all the travels that I've had, this is one of the bands that I have wanted to be able to share time with the most. And I say that because, as was mentioned earlier, I am from Centralia. Represent Panthers. I'm from Centralia. I know what that's like, particularly to be in a smaller community and have all the things that go with that. For me, being in the All-District Band was the best band I had ever been in until I made the All-State Band. So I hope in some small way they've had as much fun as I have had, because this experience would not be possible for me personally without numerous people. I mean, my high school band director, Rob Goad, was very patient with me. I tried as a freshman. I had no idea what I was doing. None. And then he was like, okay, let's try this. And then, you know, I made it the second year. And then I went to Allstate in Columbia, and I didn't know what I was doing there either. And then I learned, and then you made that band too. So the point is that at every stop of the way, I've had a lot of great mentors. Some of my professors, and talk about pressure, some of my professors and mentors are sitting in the audience right now. And I also want to give a shout out to some of my classmates, Mr. Blankenship and Julie McGuire Swope and any of a number of other folks that went to school with me. It was a special time to be here at Truman State. And I can tell you without fear of correction that I wouldn't be here today doing what I'm doing at the collegiate level without first experiencing the great artistic development that I was able to get through participation in the All-District and All-State bands, patient music educators in this part of the state, many of whom I'm still friends with and colleagues with now, and coming to Truman State. I'm not a paid endorser, but I am a three-time alum, if that tells you anything. So again, thank you very much for your patience. It really has been a joy to work with these students today, and as I said, I hope they've enjoyed it as much as I have. So we're going to finish with a composition by Randall Standridge. They're not going to lose their ever-loving minds on this piece because they're going to play with all those good I'm saying that because it's an inside joke between us, but they're going to play with all the good fundamentals and everything that they've been demonstrating, but this is a piece called Steel, and we hope you enjoy this. Again, thank you for coming out this evening.